Thank you for your patience, everyone. God bless you, and welcome to Saint Germain on Advanced Alchemy. I'm David Christopher Lewis, the co-founder of the Heart Center community. And you all love Saint Germain, right?
Yeah.
He's the alchemist of the seventh era, the Aquarian age, and he's the god of freedom to the earth and the wonder man of Europe. You've probably heard of that. And so today I'm very privileged to be with you here in Los Angeles to share with you some concepts that he shared with me. And we have two books. There's the first volume right here, Saint Germain on Advanced Alchemy, and the subtitle is Heart Streaming and the Aquarian Age. And then the second volume, which just came out in November, Saint Germain on Advanced Alchemy, Discover Alchemical Formulas for the Aquarian Age. So what is Advanced Alchemy? Saint Germain shared in the first volume that advanced alchemy is divine love practically applied. Divine love practically applied. Aquarian alchemy involves what he has called heart streaming, which involves engaging our heart's spiritual fire in co-creative work with our source, the divine God. Heart streaming is more powerful than brainstorming, for the energetic biofield of the heart is much larger than what the brain emanates. Have you heard of heart math? Some of you? So you know that is true from their scientific research, and that coherence is a key to this heart streaming and this beautiful field of energy that we co-create with our divine source through our hearts. Divine love through poetry, music, and video. This video is a poem that I wrote on divine love, and we put it to music and then to video.
My heart is pure, my heart is true. My God, I am in love with you. I raise my heart in praise of you. I trace your grace in song to you. Through alchemy I play with you, in humble service pray with you, in contemplation think of you, in meditation muse on you, in adoration sing to you, in pure devotion chant with you, in tasks and duties work for you, in daily labor strive with you. My mind is free when you are near, my soul with thee is always clear. I raise my will to merge with thine. I praise thy being now wed to mine. My spirit sure ensconced in light is fused with yours expansive bright. Oh God, I thank you for each day to love you so in every way. My heart is pure, my heart is true. My God, I am in love with you. My heart is pure, my heart is true. My God, I am in love with you. I raise my heart in praise of you. I trace your grace in song to you. Through alchemy I play with you. In humble service pray with you. Contemplation, think of you. In meditation, muse on you. In adoration, sing to you. In pure devotion, chant with you. In tasks and duties, work for you. In daily labor, strive with you. My mind is free when you are near. My soul with thee is always clear. I raise my will to merge with thine. I praise thy being now wed to mine. My spirit sure ensconced in light is fused with yours expansive bright. Oh God, I thank you for each day to love you so in every way. My heart is pure, my heart is true. My God, I am in love with you.
So divine magic is another term for alchemy. Saint Germain, as many of us know, was embodied as Merlin, the magician, who helped King Arthur during the Arthurian time in England. Advanced alchemy as co-creation. When we take a leap in consciousness to be a co-creator with God, it is the seminal decision that places us on a course toward our full liberation from the rounds of rebirth through our ascension. So do you all feel that you are now co-creators with God? Great. You may have heard of the Russian mystic Anastasia, or Anastasia, who has wonderfully shared how important co-creation is to the establishment of the Aquarian Age, which Saint Germain, through me, has called the Golden Crystal Age of Aquarius. How many crystals do we have here at the Expo? Thousands and probably tens of thousands of crystals. Many of us work with crystals, and we use crystals in our healing work, in our homes, to focus light. Well, they used crystals on Atlantis, and what happened? They misused it, and Atlantis sank. Light is the alchemical key. This is the image on the cover of my new book, which a friend of mine named David Kyle did, and he's got elemental spirits, fairies, who can help us in our alchemical work. Saint Germain said long ago that light is the alchemical key. So let us meditate on light for the Golden Age with this 5-minute meditation, which we can't show you. Although the visuals are great, if you have an alchemical project you are working on, you may also choose to close your eyes, listen to the music, and visualize it being precipitated as a reality in your life and world now. So do you all feel that you are alchemists already? How many people you already are doing alchemical work? Okay, those who aren't quite there yet, you can be an alchemist, and you'll see how. Alchemy is a true divine science. And, you know, to be spiritual, you don't have to reject true scientific understanding and knowledge. In fact, in the Aquarian Age, we unite science and spirituality. It's not religion, it's spirituality. Now, Saint Germain has talked about us using in advanced alchemy what's called the solar sciences of the spirit. He encourages us to study these solar sciences. What are they? Surya Yoga, which is sun yoga. Have you heard of Surya, the god, and the Hindu tradition, the sun god? And Omran Mikhail Ivanov, a great spiritual master who was born in Bulgaria, taught in France for nearly 50 years, said that the yoga of Aquarius would be Surya Yoga, sun yoga. And they meditated every morning before the sunrise at what's called dawn. Dawn is actually 30 minutes before the sunrise. They would watch the sun rise from the sacred rock in southern France and meditate, and they absorbed the frequencies of the sun through the sun's rays with all the divine intelligence. And then through doing that practice day after day, year after year, you become sun-like. You become like a sun. Solar meditation, what I just shared. Solar gazing. It's safe to actually look at the sun, and HRM, a great being of light from India, taught us in Bozeman, Montana, many years ago in 2007 about safe solar gazing. You start with 10 seconds, and it's only for the first hour after the sun rises that you can do this. You add 10 seconds every day, up to 45 minutes. HRM reached the point where he didn't have to eat anymore. Why? Because his pineal gland was stimulated by the light of the sun, and his pineal gland was 2.5 times larger than most of us by doing solar gazing. So you're taking in that light of the sun with its divine intelligence. It's stimulating the pineal gland, which in most of us is in a quiescent state, not fully developed. Yet that is how you gain greater divine intelligence and you become an alchemist. And you can also use in solar healing with the sun's rays, the crystals and gemstones through which you refract that light to then perform alchemy. Solar nutrition, eating foods and liquids charged with the sun's rays and energy. I studied the tradition of the Essenes with the Essene Gospel of Peace when I was 17, became a vegetarian, and life has been great since. So I think most of us desire to eat what is closer to the sun and what the sun precipitates in our world through plant life that has the chlorophyll, and chlorophyll is very close to hemoglobin. So I know there's some cultures that never do blood transfusions, human to human. Instead of hemoglobin, they take chlorophyll, which is only one atom different from the hemoglobin molecule. Solar or pranic breathing. This is very important. I think all of us here have engaged in deep, rhythmic, slow pranic breathing. It is so healing. It is one of the most powerful solar sciences. Solar bathing, nude sunbathing in a private protected area, is very healthy for all of our organs, all of the systems in our body temple. This practice will come back more in the Aquarian age because we really require the sun. When we have the right elements within us and the right diet, solar bathing is fine, and you can be in the sun for a half hour at a time and even more and not have any detrimental effects on your body and your skin. Solar astrology. Now, how many people understand that mundane astrology deals with the position of the planets and the stars in relation to the earth, right? Mundane astrology, mundane earth. Well, Saint Germain and the divine director, his teacher, shared with me that in the Aquarian age, we will have a whole astrology that's based on the position of the planets from the relationship of being from the sun, our sun, because that is a more powerful astrology. And when we understand that, it will help us to incorporate those truths, that wisdom, into our lives to become more sun-like. So our goal is to become solar beings, fully ensconced. Like Mother Mary, it says, the woman clothed with the sun and the moon under her feet and around her head, 12 stars. Solar gardening. My wife and I established Paradise Permaculture Institute in Montana. Many of you do wonderful organic gardening or maybe dynamic farming, biodynamic farming using the principles taught by the Austrian scientist and spiritualist, what's his name?
Rudolf Steiner.
Okay. And his system was very mystical and interesting and unique, but it works. And I've been on a biodynamic farm in South Africa of thousands of acres, and he used the Rudolf Steiner systems, and his crops were amazing. So how many people engage in permaculture or at least organic farming or gardening? Well, I hope more of you do that. You can even do stuff in your home with sprouting and microgreens. If you don't have a lot of space, I encourage you to do sprouting and microgreens. And then studying sacred geometry and the divine metaphysics of the multiverse. Now, we didn't hear this term multiverse or multiverses until more recently, right? The last few years. Because we thought it was universe, one verse, one system. Well, now we know there are multi-dimensions of being, and we are all multidimensional beings. Saint Germain speaks of that in this book and reveals some of these secrets. So here he is with a tetrahedron and precipitated by his cosmic consciousness. Here's, it's not the real Anastasia image from the books, but Anastasia speaks of your kin's domain and space of love. Has anybody read the Anastasia books? Beautiful books. I highly recommend them. There's 9, and I think there's a 10th book now. And then organic gardening, farming, permaculture. Jeff Lawton, who's a great permaculturist, said, all the world's problems can be solved in a garden. Isn't that beautiful? Why? Because we're meditating with the plants, the elemental life, the nurturing energies of the stars even. And the stars, remember, every star is a sun. And so the rays of God consciousness from every star impacts the plants at nighttime in their quiescent state, but it's still embedding within them these amazing quintessences from the divine world. So those of you who are very sensitive in your gardening practices can even communicate with the elemental forces and the beautiful angel devas who enjoy overshining alchemists who love nature. So if you love plants and you love nature, naturally you're going to gain the communion with these great beings of light who will teach you directly their secrets. Just like the native peoples of many cultures understand what every plant is used for, how do they learn that? Through direct communication with these beautiful beings that are the plants. So this is very interesting. Back last month on January 9th, just a little over a month ago, a master came to me and said, we'd like to share with you 10 new commandments, new Aquarian 10 commandments. This kind of replaces the old Orthodox Judaic Mosaic law. That's very old. Thou shalt not, right? All those. With the Aquarian model. So the first Aquarian commandment is love and praise God with your entire being. And I'm not going to read all the subtitles here because of time, because I'd like to give you time to ask questions and stuff. Two, radically forgive everyone for everything. Have we done that? You know, I do soul-raising sessions, and one of the sessions is with Kuan Yin, and it's about radical forgiveness of self and other. So if you're having issues with your own health or relationship problems, try Ho'oponopono, try radical forgiveness, because I assure you, if you learn this science and you utilize it, you're going to save yourself a lot of problems. You're going to heal yourself as well as help to heal others. Pray and sing your prayers joyfully without ceasing. So I think our life becomes a prayer. Our breathing becomes a prayer. Our emanations from our aura is like a prayer. When we're in the space of love and we love all life free, and we're free because we love. Serve and give selflessly every day. So my prayer when I leave my home is to the Holy Spirit to just help me help someone that day in some way that requires help. And naturally, it seems like every time I say that prayer, somebody comes into my life that I can assist. And it's a beautiful thing to help people. Keep your harmony and avoid reactivity. Now, this is an interesting one, because anytime you react with a little bit of emotional energy, what happens? You lose a little essence of your soulfulness. So the less reactive we are, the better, because we maintain that harmonic state of beauty, and our aura is serene and majestic and glorious. So when we react, what happens? Our solar plexus is agitated, and then our aura diminishes. Avoid all gossip, maintain a happy disposition, and don't complain about anything. So try doing that for one whole day. And then after you master it for a day, do it for another day, and then a week, and a month. This is a hard one, you know, to never complain about anything. What is complaining? Well, Eckhart Tolle says it's not being in the now. When you're complaining, you're not in the eternal now. So watch yourself, observe your thoughts, your feelings, and choose to be in the eternal now, which is timeless and spaceless. The eternal now is beyond time, right? And between the breaths is where the Holy Spirit exists within us, between each breath, that pause, which is the mystical, timeless, cosmic space where we intuit what is real. We perceive what is divine. We are in that state of the unity field of beingness. Be kind to all life forms, including yourself. Sometimes we're not kind to ourselves. We have self-talk that's defeating and not in our own best interest. So we have to have enlightened self-interest. Take the time to meditate, to pray, to go within, and then you will gain all these great intuitional advantages that will lead you to the apex of your selfhood in God, which is the ascension. And of course, follow the golden rule. I mean, everything hangs on that, really. If we do unto others what we desire to be done to us, then we'll never have any problems. And obey your inner guide and guardian angel immediately. So how many times have we been prompted to do something, we didn't do it immediately, and then we had an accident or something happened that wasn't optimal for us? Yet it takes the responsiveness, the obedience, the responsiveness to that inner voice that's key. Now, this may not seem like alchemy, but I assure you, Saint Germain says all of these things are alchemical, because alchemy is about divine consciousness. It's not turning human lead into human gold. It's turning the lead of our human consciousness into the divine gold of our Christ consciousness, of our Buddhic awareness, our Krishnaic beingness. You know, if you like Krishna, like all the Krishnas that were here earlier. So the violet flame, how many people use the violet light, the violet flame, the violet laser light? So this is Saint Germain's great gift to the earth through the I Am dispensation, the Saint Germain Foundation in the last century, through the Bridge to Freedom, the Summit Lighthouse, the Heart Center activity. And all of us now know about the violet light. We're wearing violet colors. We love violet. It's now part of our culture, especially in here in Los Angeles. Saint Germain talked to me about the violet laser light. One key to transmuting our past negative karma is to invoke this violet transmuting flame through prayers, mantras, songs, and dancing. Did you know that the 3-4 dance rhythm invokes the violet light? That's in a later slide. Saint Germain shared with me about 10 years ago an accelerated version of the violet flame as violet laser light. It's the seventh rainbow ray focused through amethyst crystal in a beam that we can direct into anything that is problematic to dissolve and consume it with perfect love. So let's say you have an issue with anything and you haven't solved it, you haven't resolved it. Well, take an amethyst crystal, project light through it from your heart. See it going into a situation, maybe a relationship, if you have money problems and precipitating abundance, and see the alchemy of the seventh ray going into that and focalizing it and precipitating what you truly desire with righteousness, and watch the effects. So here's the waltzing with Saint Germain's beloved, whose name is
Portia.
And she's mentioned by Shakespeare in one of the Shakespearean plays,
The Merchant of Venice,
Portia. So she remained ascended in the ascended state while he was embodying on earth to hold the balance for him, for his mission, over many lifetimes. So we had a violet laser light song that's really fun with a cool rhythm.
Violet laser light, come charge us as we pray. Violet laser light, now blaze through us today. Violet laser light, transmute this all consume. Violet laser light, we do expand and bloom.
Radical forgiveness, I've spoken a little bit about this. Ho'oponopono is phenomenal. And I have a little story. My wife's mother liked to complain about her health all the time. It was like every time we call her and say, how are you doing? Well, I feel terrible today. And it was the same every time. Well, I finally got kind of, you know, tired of this. So I decided to sit on my couch, both my wife and I did, for a half hour. We did Ho'oponopono, and I felt this click and my consciousness because I worked on myself. That's what you do in Ho'oponopono. You work internally. And if you observe something in another that you don't like, you have it in yourself. Because we're all divine beings, right? So I worked on this energy that I perceived in her of complaining about her health. So I felt that click. It was phenomenal. And I went to bed. She called the next day, asked my wife for forgiveness, said she had been a bitch to my wife, her daughter, for many years. She apologized for that. And she said she loved us. So she almost used the words of the homeowner prayer in her call. I love you. I'm sorry. Would you forgive me? And then when she hung up, thank you so much. It was amazing that it happened that quick. But I wasn't trying to change her. Yes, I was in one sense, but it was enlightened self-interest change internally, where I had to work deeply on myself, and I did. I found elements of that awareness in deep inside of me, in my subconscious, that when I asked for the transmutation of that, it performed this alchemy, and it was wonderful, and it was a beautiful experience. So I've done that many times since, problems with, you know, other situations, and it always works when I'm in the space of forgiving totally, and I go into my own godhood. So, has anybody tried Ho'oponopono and had a similar miraculous situation, right? Beautiful. So, here's an image from David Kyle, the artist for my recent books, on forgiveness precipitating a glorious level of transmutation with an angel over the meditator. Here's Saint Germain, a twinkle of mirth on earth. Do you know the actor Jake Gyllenhaal, or I don't know how you say his name. Right. I saw him on either Jimmy Kimmel or whatever, and he pronounced the true pronunciation of his name. Well, I think he looks a little bit like Saint Germain. Okay. So, the ascension is the ultimate fulfillment of our spiritual alchemies. I think we're all striving for our ascension. Yet, what is the ascension? It's simply union with God, and letting go and surrendering is a major part of that. Have you read the book, The Surrender Experiment, some of you? Amazing book. So the ascension is not an escape from our earthly work and responsibilities. It's the completion of our highest givingness to our family, community, and the world, and our highest love etched within this world of form. Saint Germain encourages us to leave our legacy on earth so our example may inspire others. I had another beautiful visual on the ascension. Let's see if we can play it. Thank you. Here's Saint Germain as the seventh angel. There's some who consider in the book of Revelation the seventh angel as actually Saint Germain revealing the deeper mysteries of life now for this time period. So it's interesting. So this artist kind of made Saint Germain into an angel. Even though he's not technically of the angelic realm, he's considered the seventh angel. What I'd like to do now, we have a couple options. I can either open it up for questions and answers, or Saint Germain can give a very short, direct message through me. Would you like that?
Yes.
Okay. So you can just relax, have your feet flat on the floor if possible, or in the lotus if you're comfortable. Breathe deeply. My beloved friends of light, here in Los Angeles, I am present with you in the fullness and the effulgence of my I Am God presence to shine forth the light of the seventh era, the seventh ray into your life stream as a blessing, as a boon, as an engagement with spirit and a divine activation of all within you that is real, pure, holy, and godly. When you enter into your own spirit of the I am there facilitating the rebirth within you of all that is majestic, dynamic, and in and through this invitation, there is the energy of the Holy Spirit manifest from deep within your soul, rising to the heart chakra, blazing forth that pure love stream through your heart, and then out into the world of form to transform all in the glorious essence of its majesty and perfection. Let us perform, dearest ones, an experiment now and see this light of the violet fire descending from the great central sun and through your own sun within this solar system now into the earth and specifically into the area of Los Angeles, the city of the angels. See anything that you observe that you do not desire, transformed, transmuted, and activated in a new and powerful way to bring forth this Aquarian model of the solar civilization that is even now being given birth to through your heightened awareness of its manifestation. See those who are burdened through the use of drugs with mental issues that they have not been able to resolve and overcome, lifted up, raised up within the violet light and fired by its brilliance, its divine connectivity to their I Am presence, and see the resolution of all issues surrounding homelessness and those encampments of the forgotten, the forlorn, even in this area where you live, move, and have your being, and the resolution to help these poor hearts. See the violet light moving through this entire area, transmuting darkness, resolving the issue of my greatest concern in this hour upon the earth, human trafficking, sex slavery, and see those caught in this web freed from the impositions of those who have little God light within their auras, who have performed dark deeds within Hollywood and elsewhere, and see now the angels of the sacred fire sustaining this action for a fortnight and more for the freeing of many who have been enslaved in this way. You, dearest hearts, are alchemists with me in this alchemy of the sacred fire. And by our togetherness, our oneness in spirit, a new world is born here, and there is broadcast from this place, here, at the Conscious Life Expo 2023, a new world awareness. And every soul herein receives my blessing this night, the alchemy of joy and the radiance of the Holy Spirit, gracing their presence and performing alchemy after alchemy in their lives as a permanent upliftment of their soul and spirit toward their ascension. Dearest hearts, I love you with a love that shall live on past this lifetime unto that time of your eternal oneness with God. And I will be there if you choose for me to be so when you ascend to lend the momentum of my heart toward that alchemy and that initiation of your reunion with your God. Would you have this, dearest ones, with me?
Yes.
Then it is so, and I bless you in the name of all that is real, all that is pure, all that is holy, as your beloved Sanctus Germanus. God bless you. So we have approximately 10 minutes now for questions and answers. And if anybody has a question, I don't know if we have a traveling mic in the back or not, with the if there's an AV guy. If not, I'll just repeat your question if you have one. So anybody with a question? Yes, sir.
First of all, thanks for that meditation. That's really awesome.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
My question is, when you had the list earlier, you combined sacred geometry with multiverse. I mean, I'm not familiar with sacred geometry at all. I studied math, but I love multiverse. Is there a reason why you combined them in that top 10 list or 5 or whatever?
Okay. You want me to go back here?
Yeah, it was the small print at the beginning.
Here.
Yeah, the very top.
Studying sacred geometry and divine metaphysics of the multiverse. Well, sacred geometry involves... See, the geometry of divinity is God. God geometrized the universe. And sacred geometry is in every part of life and nature. When we delve into the secrets of the creation of the universe, we find these mysteries revealed, like through the pi and the spiral. What do you call the...
Fibonacci.
So what is sacred geometry? It is the architecture of the universe. And in the Hindu tradition, Vastu, anybody familiar with Vastu? We have Vastu temples that we in the Heart Center, we've created 3 of them, one in Arizona, one in Mount Shasta, one in south of Livingston, Montana. And the Vastu science was given to the earth by Manu, or Mana, I believe, who was Sanakumara, the Ancient of Days, also known as Kartikeya. So geometry and true metaphysics helps us to understand the structure of the universe, just as the tree of life in Kabbalah with the spherot, the 10 spherot or sephirot, that is an architectural image of how the universe is created by these great cosmic beings. So that's a very short explanation, but you know, divine science and spirituality go hand in hand, and when we understand science in the true sense, it's very enlightening and very enriching and very fun. So I like to find codes within nature, codes within, you know, my daily life. You know, we just had 2/3/23, you know, February 3rd. I mean, things like that, they're fun. They're fun to use mathematics to understand who we are. And I think the day you were born is important, the time you were born, where you were born. Everything is kind of pre-planned. We pre-plan our lives. And when we understand, you know, where we are within the universe, we can divine our divine destiny. So, I don't know, that's just a short explanation. Thank you. Anybody else? So, oh, go ahead.
Is there a sign about soul-raising sessions, and you said something about...
Okay, well, at our booth 306, I do soul-raising sessions, and first they were just with the Holy Spirit, and they're beautiful, and we have 5-minute, 10-minute, 20-minute sessions here. Recently, starting in January 9th, Serapis Bay is coming with help with the Ascension, Kathumi on resolving your psychology, Mother Mary with helping with family issues, family relationships, resolving any issues in your relationships, and Kuan Yin on radical forgiveness of self and other. We also have a session with the Divine Director. We're not doing that here, but I do them virtually. The Divine Director was Saint Germain's guru, and he helps with you help discerning your divine plan. If you have trouble like with figuring out what to do next or like the long-term vision of your life, he will guide you. He won't tell you everything, but he'll facilitate guiding you. And the Divine Director is very similar to Ganesh in the Hindu tradition. He basically is like the same being. Yes, sir.
The words you mentioned about solar gazing concerns me, because some people go blind. I mean, when it works well, but sometimes it doesn't work. And what are the risks?
Well, the risks are you have to follow and only start with 10 seconds. And you can only do it the first hour after the sunrise. If you do it in the middle of the day, you could burn your retina. If you start out and go 3 minutes immediately, that's a problem. You start with 10 seconds. You add 10 seconds only each day. This is what HRM, Hiram Montek. That's what he taught us. And he had been doing it for many, many years. He was commissioned by Babaji to teach this in the West and all over the world. Babaji told him to do this. So he figured out how to do it safely. The ancients did it. The Egyptians did it. Many of the mystical brotherhoods in the past did it. The mystery schools in Crotona with Kathumi as an embodiment as Pythagoras, they did solar gazing. And the Hindu tradition is one of the most ancient traditions with the Mahabharata and the Upanishads. They understood this because they revered Surya as the sun god, and they did it. The Egyptians, Akhenaten, they have images of them. They call it worshiping the sun. Well, it wasn't worshiping the sun. It was collaborating with the sun and using the sun's divine consciousness to help them in their civilization.
So and of course, done correctly, it always works.
But you can't just jump the gun. How much time do we have? 5 minutes? Okay. You can't jump the gun.
It's like Kundalini yoga, that if it's done incorrectly.
Kundalini yoga done incorrectly, you can go insane. Yeah. And you can hurt yourself if you don't do solar gazing properly.
Yeah.
And you also stand on the earth, preferably with bare feet, to anchor the sun's rays through your legs and feet into the earth. That's also important as part of the process. So HRM taught this. There are videos. There's videos online. You can understand the science. So I'm just going to quickly move to the end here. I do these sessions at our booth, and I also do them online anytime. Be merciful to all, and you'll make much greater spiritual progress. Here's Kuan Yin, Saint Germain again. Here's my second book, my first book on alchemy. We have also the first book in Spanish at our booth. We are having an event in Vista, California, down near San Diego, on this coming Tuesday and Wednesday at Dennis's home, Dennis Stan. It's the Temple of Clarity. It's a beautiful, beautiful home in the evening, just in the evenings. And then we have prayer vigils. I'm going to Mexico next month. If any of you are of Mexican descent or you'd like to go there, we have a beautiful event at a retreat center near Cuernavaca. We have our summer solstice event in Chicago area, and then autumn equinox in Mount Shasta.
Yay!
I love Mount Shasta. I go there every year. And then we are having an event at the winter solstice, but it's going to be projected, I think, to Chile. I don't know if I'll be able to go. I hope so. If they require vaccines, I'm not going to enter the country. And then we have a free daily broadcast for 2 hours. We have our Meru University online courses. The whole Advanced Studies in Alchemy course with Saint Germain was phenomenal. It lasted, I think, 10 weeks. It was great. And then I've given classes on higher alchemy and divine abundance with Saint Germain and Fortuna, and that's it. So, God bless you.